Hi peeps. How y'all doing this evening? Today is April 25th, Monday.
At
5:25 in the PM. And yeah, cause me and my kids just got through reading. We're still reading this book. And I decided that I'm finna do my story time. Yeah, that's what I'm getting ready to do, peeps. And I think that 30-minute video idea woke me out and traumatized me. I'm like, that won't happen no more. So yeah, let's get it. And I got my tripod set up now. No, yeah, moving on up. But yeah, I'm getting ready to read this part of the story, "The Power of Praying for Your Adult Children." It's I'm reading page 117, and what's that? And I'm on chapter 7, and the topic is have a sound mind and a right attitude. And when we read this, we just ate dinner, so I got a lot of stuff going on right now. Anyways, I'm not in my normal setup, which is my room, the hubby in there, and I don't want to disturb him. And I normally do my story time during my lunch, but my lunch be going by so fast, so I'm like, this time I have free. I ain't doing nothing. Well, I was watching vlogs, trying to play some video games, Facebook games. I'm like, let me just do my story time. We just got to walking through the house, praying over the house and stuff. So it triggered this to do this. Yeah. Sonny, what you doing back there? Making all them sound effects.
Just drinking some tea.
You what?
Drinking some tea.
Mm-hmm. You go, I think you're trying to steal my shine, son.
You moved the camera. You moved it.
I know, but wasn't nobody back there. And if you were sitting down, I probably wouldn't even see you like that. I can't see you now. I'm out. If we back there, I can't see. Okay. No, I can't. I cannot afford to begin distracted, son. Cause I've been on a whole nother subject. Started talking about a whole nother book. Yeah. Have a sound mind and right attitude. It's not that long, but yeah, nevertheless. Let me get right into it. It say none of us really knows what another person is thinking. Very few people, if any, share their every thought with someone else. Not even husband and wives, not even in close relationship between parents and adult children. The truth is, only God knows all of our thoughts. I'm gonna edit you out. I'm gonna blur you. That's why he is the one to go to regarding what goes on in the mind and emotions of your adult child. Some of the greatest struggles many of our adult children have to face are those that happen in their minds. The enemy will always try to get them to believe his lies and reject God's truth. He knows that as long as they believe his lies, he has won. We all can have thoughts that plague us by playing over and over in our heads, even causing manifestations in our physical bodies, such as pain, nausea, nauseous, disease, or the inability of our bodies to do what they are supposed to do. Our thoughts can not only make us sick in our body, but in our minds and emotions as well. One wrong thought can cause us to fail in life. If we believe a lie about ourselves instead of what the Word of God says about us. For example, if we constantly say, I always fail at everything, instead of I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Turning the page. We are more likely to experience failure. The problem is that too often we believe the lie is the truth because we are not clear on what God's truth is. And we hear the screaming voice of the enemy to our minds, which is so much louder than the still and small voice of God to our souls. The Bible says of the enemy that there is no truth in him, but he is a liar and the father of it. John 8:44. Everyone is susceptible to that kind of mental torment, but our adult children even more so. Because no matter how much noise, distraction, and worldly input we were exposed to growing up, they had much worse. They have every kind of electronic device vying for their attention. Some young adults have had their eyes, ears, and minds plugged into something other than the Lord for years. Whatever captured their eyes and ears will also capture their minds and hearts. Suicides or murderous rampages of teenagers and young adults all begin as a seed of a lie planted in their minds through their eyes or ears, or it festers and grows silently in the dark parts of their soul. Negative emotions such as anger, hurt, rejection, fear, anxiety, and loneliness all fuel and feed the lie so it can grow until it is out of control. A person who believes he is rejected will become hurt, anxious, and fearful, then lonely and isolated, and finally angry. All of these negative aspects of his personality will cause people to reject him even more. And so, the lie grows until it becomes not only self-destructive, but destructive of other people as well. Our adult children can have lies playing in their minds that limit their ability to think clearly and accurately about themselves and their circumstances. So that's the reading, and when we read it, I thought, man, this is deep and it's true. And as the Bible say, the truth comes to set you free. And I just hope, you know, whoever watching this video, that these words speak to your heart. Speak to your mind, speak to your spiritual man, to pray over your children while they're young. And that's why the Bible said, teach your children while they're young. When they go astray, it'll bring them back. What's going to bring them back if you don't put the word down on the inside, you know? So, yeah, I just wanted to share that with you all. And I'm not going to go into like a personal story time because that was kind of like that was a long part, you know. So I'm trying to keep my videos at a minimum, people. Yeah, I am. Because I be trying to do the most when I edit. It be the most to me. To me. So, yeah. On that note, y'all, I hope y'all enjoyed that reading. And again, the topic was have a sound mind and a right attitude. And today we read, and it was another part that I liked it. So I was like, oh, wow, I gotta go and get this out before I write the next one down. And hopefully I'll do the other one next week. And normally I try to put them up on Fridays, but I probably put it up Wednesday, tomorrow, Tuesday. I don't feel like doing no editing today, Monday, and for it to go up Tuesday. So I probably load it today, edit tomorrow, and put it up Wednesday. So on that note, I hope everybody have a blessed, safe, productive Wednesday. And be safe out here, because it was an incident. Okay, a little mini story time. It was a little incident I told y'all about, a park that's like 3 or 4 blocks away. And like, I think it was Saturday, I was standing by my bedroom window, and I thought I heard some shots. The hubby was like, oh, somebody working on the roof. But no, it was actually some shots. And Sonny, he was upstairs at that time, and he had even said he heard somebody say, help me, and stuff like that. So somebody had actually got shot just right out there, like in my back. The police car was literally parked and right behind our backyard. So yeah, I don't know who it was, how serious it was, but man, right there in the back of me. That's too close for comfort, y'all. But nevertheless, God is faithful. God is our protector. And he sits high and he look low. And on that note, peace and love and share some. And I'll see y'all in my next video. I holla.